Glazing clay is time-consuming, expensive, and unpredictable. My favorite glaze alternative is this metallic dry brush over clay. It's super easy, it's very affordable, and you can get the results you want every time. I'm specifically making this video because I have a whole group of students that I had to send home with a face jug, which if you click the link above, I'll show you how to make that out of regular or air dry clay. And I had to send them home with unfinished pieces of clay. So hopefully this video, even though we can't go into the classroom and glaze, will allow my students an opportunity to do something to their finished work of art that doesn't leave it just naked. I'm using the cheapest black acrylic paint that you can get at Walmart or any craft store. You will put a coat of black acrylic paint all over your clay. Keep in mind that this is bisque fire clay, which means it's been in the kiln once, and bisque fire clay is really thirsty. So what that means is it's going to absorb your paint really quickly, and putting some water on your brush is going to help it get in the cracks and crevices. Because this is a sculpture, a three-dimensional work of art, you will need a smaller brush to get in all those cracks and crevices, and you're gonna need to move your sculpture around as you're applying your first coat. You can see I already have black acrylic paint on my fingers, which will probably happen to you too, and you definitely wanna wear an apron or clothes that you don't mind getting paint on. Even if you're super clean, if you get this paint on yourself, unless you get it out before it sets, it will be with you forever. Let's speed things up a little bit now that you get the idea. Check your work as you go that you don't miss any spots, because this has to be completely dry before you do your metallic paint. My face jug sat in front of a fan for 45 minutes and I'm ready for my first coat of molten chroma acrylic paint. There are lots of different brands of acrylic paint on the market. This is the one that I use in the classroom because it's really affordable and really easy to work with. What I love about this dry brush technique is you can't mess it up. You've seen me do this before on a figure sculpture I made out of paper mache, and I put the full tutorial above. I never use a brand new paintbrush with this technique if I can help it, and I like to have something with kind of hard bristles. But really, any paintbrush will do the job. So this is called dry brush, and as the name implies, you will have zero water on your brush. Start by wiping a little bit of paint and then wiping most of it off, and I'm using an index card as my palette today. Lightly brush on your paint, and less is more. You can always overlap and add more paint, but the alternative is if you use too much, is you have to paint it all black and start again. So you want to see your black background. So the metallic paint is enhancing that darkness and enhancing your textures. Spread it out as you go, and working in thin layers is best. It's super important that your black acrylic paint is dry, because if not, you're gonna have a gray mess on your hands. Keep going, repeating these steps until you have one coat to the luster of your liking. And luster is just a fancy word for how shiny something is. I really love this technique because with a sculpture, you've already created three-dimensional areas that show depth, but this technique creates highlights and shadows that just makes your sculpture not only look really expensive, but gives it so much depth and contrast in your small sculpted and textured areas. Now that I have my base coat, I want to go in and add some accent colors. So the beauty of these metallic paints is that they all work together in unity. So really you can use any combination of them and they're gonna look awesome. My first accent color is this beautiful copper, and I'm actually using the same brush. I'm not gonna put the copper absolutely everywhere because I want the gold to stand out, but I'm gonna use it to enhance the areas that I really want to be emphasized or the viewer to be focused on. So I'm gonna do a light coat over some areas, and I do want it even, but the gold is the base color, and this is just gonna bring to life certain areas of my sculpture. So you can see how beautifully these two colors work together, and they're not competing, they just kind of glow, and you can see the black is still there. That shadow and textured area is really important. So I could go to town with this copper color. I could do this all day, it's so beautiful, but I'm gonna do one last accent color to really pop certain facial features and that sad little tear I added to my face jug. So the silver is my last one, and I'm using my smallest brush, and I'm gonna use it very sparingly. So in my eyes, on my teardrop, and then I wanna enhance some of those carved patterns that I did to make them stand out from the gold. This technique is art teacher approved because it's so inexpensive. You cannot mess it up, and no matter how many colors from this set you use, they all work together. I've had so much success with this technique from back in my days when I was a high school ceramics teacher to today when I have to send unfinished pieces of clay home with my students to hopefully have some success at home. Check it out, I'm obsessed. And even though I didn't get to glaze and put this guy back in the kiln, I feel like I have a finished work of art that I'm truly happy with. Thanks for watching, and check out my website, thatartteacher.com, for full lesson plans and student examples.